to hear and help my heart to understand. In Jesus' name, amen. Enjoy the show.
The kingdom of heaven is like a person who owned some land. One morning, he went out early to hire some people to work in his vineyard. The man agreed to pay the workers one coin for working that day. He sent them into the vineyard to work. About 9 o'clock, that man went to the marketplace and saw some other people standing there doing nothing. So he said to them, "If you go and work in my vineyard, I will pay you what your work is worth."
So they went to work in the vineyard. The man went out again about 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock and did the same thing. About 5 o'clock, the man went to the marketplace again and saw some others standing there. He asked them, "Why did you stand here all day doing nothing?" They answered, "No one gave us a job." Then the man said to them, "Then you can go and work in my vineyard."
At the end of the day, the owner of the vineyard said to the boss of all the workers, "Call the workers and pay them. Start with the last people I hired and end with those I hired first." When the workers who were hired at 5 o'clock came to get their pay, each received one coin. When the workers who were hired first came to get their pay, they thought they would be paid more than the others, but each of them also received one coin.
When they got their coin, they complained to the man who owned the land. They said those people were hired last and worked only 1 hour, but you paid them the same as you paid us who worked hard all day in the hot sun. But the man who owned the vineyard said to one of the workers, "Friend, I am being fair to you. You agreed to work for one coin, so take your pay and go. I want to give the man who was hired last the same pay that I gave you. I can do what I want with my own money. Are you jealous because I was good to those people? So those who are last will someday be first, and those who are first will now someday be last."
While Jesus was going to Jerusalem, he took his 12 followers aside privately and said to them, "Look, we are going to Jerusalem. The Son of Man will be turned over to the leading priests and teachers of the law, and they will all say he must die. They will give the Son of Man to the non-Jewish people to laugh at him, to beat him with whips, and to crucify him. But on the third day, he will be raised to life again."
Then the wife of Zebedee came to Jesus with her sons. She bowed before him and asked him to do something for her. Jesus asked, "What do you want?" She said, "Promise me that one of my sons will sit at your right side and the other will sit at your left side in your kingdom." But Jesus said, "You don't understand what you're asking. Can you drink of the cup I am about to drink?" The sons answered, "Yes, we can." Jesus said to them, "You will drink from my cup, but I cannot choose who will sit at my right or left. Those places belong to those for whom the Father has prepared them." The other 10 followers heard this, and they were angry with the two brothers. Jesus called all the followers together and said, "You know that the rulers of the non-Jewish people love to show their power over the people, and their important leaders love to use their authority. But it should not be a way among you. Whoever wants to be great among you must serve the rest of you like a servant. Whoever wants to become first among you must serve the rest of you like a slave. In the same way, the Son of Man did not come to be served. He came to serve others and to give his life as a ransom for many people."
When Jesus and his followers were leaving Jericho, a great many people followed him. 2 blind men sitting by the road heard that Jesus was going by, so they shouted, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us." The people warned the blind men to be quiet, but they shouted even more, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us. Jesus stopped and said to the blind man, What do you want for me to do for you? They answered, Lord, we want to see. Jesus felt sorry for the blind man and touched their eyes, and at once they could see. Then they followed Jesus.
Would you like to ask Jesus in your heart? I did, and I love him so much. He is going to live in my heart forever. If you would like the same thing, pray this prayer with me. Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. Thank you for taking the punishment for them. Please come into my heart. I want to know you and love you forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen.
If you have a pet that you would like to see on a special episode, have your parent or guardian email me at the email address below. The email should include your pet's name, a Bible verse you would like to hear him read, and a forward-facing photo of your pet. If you would like your name and age included, add that to the email as well. Each time we have 10 entries, we will make a special episode.
If you loved this episode, like our channel, subscribe, and ring the bell. See you next time.
Thanks for watching the show.